This video will show you how to add an automatic table of contents to your ETD document. There are a couple different ways to do this, but I will show you one way that allows you to make sure the table of contents matches the ETD formatting requirements. In order to have an automatic table of contents, you will first need to assign built-in headings to all the section and chapter titles within your ETD. Using built-in headings also makes your document more digitally accessible. As a reminder, more information about digital accessibility is available on the GW Library ETD website. It's easier to assign built-in headings once all the sections and chapters of your ETD have been finalized. I also suggest that you use the navigation pane as you assign the headings. You can open the navigation pane by going to the View tab and clicking on the button for navigation pane. Having this navigation pane visible will help you keep track of the overall structure of your document. We will be assigning headings from the Home tab and using the Styles section. If you would like, you can click on the button to open the Styles pane and assign the headings using the Styles pane. The title of your ETD should be assigned Heading 1, and your section and chapter titles should be assigned Heading 2. If you have any subchapters, they should be assigned Heading 3. So we will begin by assigning Heading 1 to the ETD title. To do this, select the text, and then if you're using the Styles pane, click on the arrow that appears next to Heading 1, and select the option to update Heading 1 to match selection. If you are using the Styles section in the Home tab, you can also do this by right-clicking on Heading 1 and then selecting Update Heading 1 to match selection. Clicking this button to update the heading to match the selection updates the style or the formatting of the heading to match the formatting of the text that has been selected. So in this case, Heading 1 has been set to have the formatting of the text that is highlighted here. You only need to select this option to update the heading to match the selection for the first time that you assign a Heading 1, Heading 2, or Heading 3 in the document. After you have set the formatting of the heading, the next time you want to assign the heading to a section or title in the text, you just need to click on the button for that heading and the heading will be assigned. And once you assign a heading to text within the document, you will see that the heading gets added to the navigation pane. So now that we have assigned Heading 1, we will now move on to assigning Heading 2s to the next sections in the document. And in this document, the next section is the dedication section. So we will assign Heading 2 by selecting the text and then clicking on the button to update Heading 2 to match selection. And you will see that dedication has now been added to the navigation pane. And when we move on to assign the heading to the next section, this time we will select the text and then this time just click on the button for Heading 2. And you will see again that it gets added to the navigation pane. Please note that when you assign Heading 2 to chapter titles or the sections that appear from chapter 1 onwards, bold font will automatically get added to the chapter or section title. In line with the ETD formatting requirements, for all of the sections that appear in the ETD from chapter 1 onwards, bold font should not be used for the chapter or section title. So once you assign these sections or chapters as Heading 2, please remember to remove the bold font from the title. And if you have any subchapters, again, please assign them as Heading 3. You're going to want to repeat this process of assigning the headings to all the sections, chapters, and subchapters throughout your ETD document. Since it will take me some time to finish this process, I will now skip forward to when all the headings have been assigned throughout the document. Now all the Heading 2s and Heading 3s have been assigned throughout the document, and you can see all of the sections appearing in the navigation pane. We will now add the table of contents to the document. To do this, you will want to place your cursor in the location of where you want the table of contents text to appear. And then from the References tab, click on Table of Contents, and then click on Custom Table of Contents. In the pop-up window, you will see that the table of contents is currently set to display heading 1, and then heading 2s and heading 3s. Because we don't want the ETD title to be displayed in the table of contents, you'll want to remove heading 1 from the table of contents. To do this, click on Options, and then in the column for TOC level, remove the number 1 that appears next to heading 1, and then click OK. Next, we're going to want to make sure that the formatting of the text in the table of contents matches the ETD formatting requirements. To do this, click on Modify, and then we will need to set the text for the heading 2s and heading 3s separately. So first, let's start with heading 2, which is listed here as TOC2. So select TOC2, and then click on Modify. And then we're going to set the formatting of the text for all the heading 2s within the table of contents. So set the font to Times New Roman, size 12. And then we want the text in the table of contents to display using double spacing. So click on the button for double spacing. And then we do not want additional space to be added in between lines. So click on the button to remove space in between lines. Then, in this example here, you might see that the text of the table of contents is starting slightly indented from the left page margin. We want the table of contents to start in line with the left page margin, so click on the button to move the indentation back to the left page margin. Then click OK. And now we need to repeat this process for setting the formatting for the heading 3s. So select TOC3, click on Modify, and then again, select Times New Roman, size 12, double spacing, and then click on the button to remove additional space in between lines. This time, because heading 3 is a subchapter, you may wish to leave the indentation that appears before heading 3. Then click OK, and again click OK. And now you will see that the formatting of the text of the table of contents matches the way that the ETD formatting requirements want it to appear. So click OK. And now you will see that your table of contents gets added to your document. So you will see all of the section and chapter titles throughout your document listed here with the page number that they appear on. And if you look closely, you will see that there is an entry for table of contents in this list. We actually don't want the table of contents section to be listed here in this table of contents. So you can go ahead and delete this entry. Also, please remember that the ETD formatting requirements require that all of the sections that appear in the document before chapter 1 should be listed here in the table of contents using bold font. So select the entries for the sections that come before chapter 1 and add bold font to the text. If text has been added to your document and the page numbers have changed, you can automatically update the page numbers listed here by clicking anywhere on the table of contents text. And then from the References tab, clicking on the button for Update Table. In the pop-up window, you will see the option to update page numbers only. So select this option and then click OK. And you will see that the page numbers will then be updated. If you have added a new section to your document, so for example, let's say you have added a new subchapter to Chapter 2, you can automatically add this new section to the table of contents as well. Again, to do this, you will click anywhere on the table of contents text, and then from the References tab, click on the button to update table. And then this time in the pop-up window, click on the option to update entire table, and then click OK. And then you will see that the new subchapter has been added to the table of contents. When you select this option to update the entire table, the formatting of the text of the table of contents gets reset. So you may need to remove the entry for the table of contents once more, and you may need to add bold font back to the text of the sections that appear before chapter one. So this is how you add an automatic table of contents to your ETD document. Thank you for watching, and good luck with your ETD submission.